eSportBets.com – уникальное место для настоящего геймера. Только здесь возможны ставки на киберспортивные события. Ты знаешь толк в самых популярных играх и готов рисковать? Смотри регулярные трансляции и зарабатывай реальные деньги. eSportBets.com – живой азарт и холодный расчет.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the show. We are a little bit late with the server. It's not quite up and running yet, but I can still say hi to all of you and thank you for tuning in. I know that there is a lot going on tonight in the world of esports. The international number four is going to be concluded tonight with a pretty amazing best of five game. So I imagine a lot of people are going to be watching, but obviously we still want to cover as much Counter-Strike as we can. Then we'll take a sneak peek at the international every once in a while, you know, when we are in between breaks and stuff. Just keep an eye on things. A little bit of a shame that that neither Alliance or Na'Vi is there, I think, but for the finals, but that's kind of how it goes. So yeah, I'm still just waiting for the server to be up and running. I can't even really tell you much. Well, I guess I can tell you a little bit about who's going to be playing tonight, just in case you haven't seen already. This first game is going to be ESG versus USSR. Probably going to be a little bit one-sided, I imagine. ESG should be a couple of levels above USSR, but we'll see. Things change sometimes. Then it's LDLC versus Reason, then it's LDLC versus ESG, and then it's Epsilon versus ESG. And actually, in between those games, another match that we won't be covering is ESG playing on bots. So ESG have four games on the road tonight. It's a pretty packed evening for them. We'll see if they come out on alive or not. And we'll see. I think actually, yeah, now it's working, so now I can switch it over to the game. That means welcome to the show, everyone. And let me see if I can call up Semler as well on Skype. That seems important as well. Otherwise, I'll be doing it all alone. And nobody likes that. Let's see. All right, Semler's probably going to be answering in a second, and then we'll be good to go. But in the meantime, remember that on Wednesday, we're going to be doing our own Case King of the Hill tournament, which will be great fun. We'll have Na'Vi back playing, and then we have two new contestants, which I'm not going to reveal quite yet, but we have found them, so it's going to be good fun. Oh, that was set correctly, no problem. All good, wasn't it? Did I just unbind that? Yes, I did. Well played. All right, so we are going to be on Dust 2 for this game, and as I can tell, World Dead is going to be standing in on USSR's side instead of who's actually playing normally instead of World Dead. I'm so sorry, I should probably know this. I'm a little bit confused because of all these delays that we've got going on here. But normally, it would have been Flamey playing, so World Dead is standing in. It's actually a very, very good player. Don't think it'll actually sway the odds in favor of USSR. But we'll have to see. I know this game isn't on CSGO Lounge either. You couldn't bet this game, but it's not really their fault. They are working on upgrading their servers and getting everything better. So hopefully in a couple of weeks, it'll be, you know, the site will be even better. They've done a real effort to do that. Oh, Case King Facebook already announced it. Fair enough, Drake. Well, then I can just go ahead and say it. It's not really a big secret anyway, but we will be inviting Hellraisers and Epsilon to play, so that's going to be really good fun. But we'll do a little bit of advertising about it in the upcoming days as well, so you guys can know what's going on. And we'll see. Semler? I don't know. I bet he went to get something to drink because he thought he wasn't going to be able to connect to the server. Either way, guys, to go through the lineup here that we have for you guys tonight, on ESG side is Huitin Emilio, Delpan, Maikilele, and Rogue. And on USSR side, it's Keep It Real, Letro, World Edit as a stand-in, Kipakin, and Lamp. So we'll have to see how this all turns out. It is a best-of-one game for the SLTV Starseries Season 10, and you are on Room on Fire. Welcome, and thank you for joining us. Really appreciate you guys tuning in. Remember to follow and subscribe and everything else, and soon enough, Semler is going to be with us, and we will be able to get the show on the road here. Emilio saying they're ready, so now we're just waiting for USSR, and then we will be good to go. Kick off the evening here. It's almost to the point where you can just sit down and relax and watch Counter-Strike a little bit and then join in on Dota later on. It's pretty smart. We'll see. I'm going to call up Semler again. There we go.
Hello.
Finally some success. What's up, Semler?
Sorry about that. I was running all over the place.
It's all right. We haven't missed anything. It's going to be just fine.
Do we still have the? Do we still have an issue with the server? Or are we able to get onto it now?
We are able to get on. Should be okay. Working. In fact, they are doing live rounds, so your timing is pretty good.
Perfect. Perfect. There's so much going on right now because, as we all know, there's obviously the TI4 finals going at the same time. So for those of you with two monitors, rejoice. And for those of you without, well, we appreciate you guys picking us over them because, you know, who cares about Dota anyway? So, guys, tonight is actually going to be pretty good. I believe we have four games here for the SLTV group stage, and we're starting off with ESG USSR, so the Swedes versus the Ruskies.
Exactly right, and for some reason, they've taken a very long time doing this knife round. Not that it really matters that much on Dust 2, so I don't know why they're taking it so seriously, but I think they are just having a fun old time here. But, I mean, at this point, I mean, the size of the Dota 2 international prize pool is obviously such that it's almost like even if you've never even watched a single game of Dota, you kind of want to watch the grand finals anyway, just because.
I feel like it's the same kind of hype that was around the League of Legends Worlds, you know, where they did they had the finals in the the Staples Center, which is the stadium that the Los Angeles Lakers and the hockey team, the Kings, you know, they all play out of that stadium. And whenever something big happens, it's out of that stadium. So it's the same sort of thing, right? It's the same sort of feel where it's just like it's so big you have to watch it even if you don't play the game.
That is what it feels like. But yes, again, thanks for joining us, guys. Now the game is live. Grenade going to be out onto Long, and Emilio actually catches almost none of that damage. Thought that was going to hit him pretty well. But instead, ESG actually survived that situation much better than they should. Emilio eventually does get shot down to 14 health, but they could have lost both players out on Long. Then it's a very dangerous position to get caught in.
Yeah, that smoke, I think, really just saving them there. Despite the fact that USSR were putting shots through, just no luck for USSR that time around. They have managed to force ESG back onto the site, but ESG are fairly close. Great headshot from Keep It Real, who gets the first kill and opens up the site. But now Huiten from short is looking to put a stop to this.
Yeah, but the bomb is going to go down here, and actually USSR are in a really good position right now. Emilio's going to push through the smoke with 14 health. He still picks up a kill. Impressive play. Delpan takes one as well, and somehow it's into a 3-on-2 now. Just World Edit and Latro waiting, and World Edit will take one. He's the stand-in here, doing fine, and oh, incredible work here. Taking down three players, Rogue and Delpan will fall. They ran right into that. Man, I'm still impressed that ESG brought it that far back, because as soon as Mike Lilla went down, they really lost the bomb side in a big way. But those last two kills were just great.
Was it Delpan or was it Huiten? I think it was Huiten who actually got caught. Unfortunately, ESG, they chucked an incendiary grenade out that stopped Huiten from being able to push the site. So they couldn't actually go for a pincer movement on World Edit, who was sticking in Goose. So that's just like an unfortunate chain of events that led to ESG having to turn it into like one push, and then World Edit just lands the sickest shots to make up for it. So it's just, I mean, ESG, they came close, but World Edit, there's no like real accounting for it. It's like the Shoxi factor, right? It's just some guy who goes nuts and gets three kills.
Oh, Shoxi. We'll be seeing him later tonight, and I think everyone's a little bit excited about how well he's going to be playing. Certainly at DreamHack Valencia, he showed us that he's not forgotten everything. This time they're going to be pushing up on short towards the A-bomb side, and they're not really facing much of a contest here. It's just pistols, not even any armor going on for ESG. They bought, you know, some P250s, and that's about it. So second round for USSR pretty easily picked up.
Yeah, and that's going to make you think, like, they're not, because they actually spent money in the second round, they're obviously not going to go for like a FAMAS buy or anything like that in this round. Yeah. ESG are really just looking to maximize their money. So this makes you think, are they going to go for like a double op play?
Yeah.
Or are they, you know, because Delpan is obviously going to be wanting to get that sniper rifle very quickly, but Michelele can also snipe very well for ESG. So do they have that in mind? Something crazy to start things off here versus USSR.
Well, they're already doing something really cool, flashing and actually boosting up into catwalk and then all rushing in the middle. I kind of wish they'd committed to it and just kept going, because now instead they've given time for USSR to readjust and accept, you know, just adjust to the fact that there's such an aggressive push going on. If they just kept going, maybe they could have killed Kibakken and got off to a slightly better start here. But I think now that USSR know that ESG's playing this way, they're going to be super careful.
Yeah, ESG have made the right call, and they actually do benefit from it. They get one kill, but now they're just going to get mowed down. Rogue gets another one. Great play from him. That's all he's going to get now. That leaves Huiten alive at mid-doors. But ESG got the right read. USSR decided to go out long, which is a good call from them at the same time if ESG don't catch on to that fact and try and start shifting defense over there. ESG had two guys there before USSR even made it out the door, so they were able to actually turn this into a pretty decent eco round, getting two kills.
Yeah, now the just the one guy left who's gonna get shut down. But you're right, that is a good call from ESG. And they get the two kills, so that's a really successful eco round. Now we're going to be going to the fourth one, and the question about the AWPs is about to be answered. Actually, mainly Rogue would be able to pick up one here, but he's not gonna. It's going to be Delpan, which is not a big surprise. But that means Delpan without any head armor, which is not so fun against the two Galils, and also no grenades at all. So he's got to be a little bit careful, but I still think it's a great idea. When you have Delpan, you got to use Delpan, right?
Yeah, that's just Delpan for you, right? But what's really interesting is it's a double op play for USSR. Keep it real and World Edit. World Edit already picking up a frag on long. That's Michelele down. So ESG really suffering already in this fourth round, which is, I mean, very important for them. This first buy round is a big opportunity for them to get on the board and start getting that momentum that is so important on Dust 2 to start shifting their way. And it's just not happening for them. They're already down. And now they have to come up with some big kills to slow USSR down.
What's really interesting is that ESG actually went for a really slow push down on long, where they had a really great setup with flashbangs and everything. They're really anticipating that someone might be looking there, and they still lost the player. So nice shot coming out from World Edit, and I think that's what we know him for as well with this AWP. That's what he's really good at. So fourth round up, Urine is looking good for USSR, but they need to close out the round. They need to do that while they still have time left on the clock. 40 seconds, it's manageable, but they got to be careful they don't run completely out here.
It does look like it's going to be a B-split after all. What I liked for a second there was Delpan's aggressive position close to dark. Instead, he's going to lend a hand to the defense on B-slope. Kibakin is going to find one, though, and that's going to turn it into a quick one-for-one. It's all down to Delpan now with that AWP on the B-side. He's about to get flanked. He's going to get caught, but he still gets one kill before getting taken out. Good work there. But this still means that ESG are down a man with a retake on B. It's not looking likely here for the Swedes.
How did he get that kill? That was very impressive, but unfortunately the showmanship of the moment isn't quite enough to actually win the round for ESG here, and a 1-on-3 equipped, and they already realize he might be coming, and there's an AWP trained right on this position, so it's not even enough. And I think a lot of people right now are going to be pretty happy that this game wasn't on CSGO Lounge to bet on, just because I think everybody almost would have gone all in on ESG. And not that it's over yet, far from over. I think they still will make it back, but you'd be really scared right now, wouldn't you, if you had been betting on them?
Yeah, I think you would be a little bit worried here, because USSR are just looking so solid. I mean, getting kills, I think that was a bit of a mistake by the man in CT to peek out, you know, when there's two guys, B retake. He should have just been, you know, hoofing it out of there, not giving USSR the opportunity to pick him off, because having two guns would have been pretty nice for ESG in this round. It could have given them a real chance. You know, maybe the team actually forces up behind it, something like that. But with only one gun to work with, there isn't a whole lot of hope here. And USSR should be set to get five rounds early on here in this half.
They already shoot a guy in the middle as Delpan trying to cross over. Those two AWPs are really proving quite effective at the moment. And I mean, I think if it was, you know, AKs versus M4s in an aim duel, I think ESG would win it. So maybe it makes a lot of sense for USSR to just say, well, when we're going to use AWPs instead, where we have Keep It Real and World Edit, and you just have Delpan. And now, right now, you don't even really have an economy to pick up an AWP on him. So that could be a pretty cool idea here.
Because this is so uncommon. ESG have got to be wondering. It also seems just very much like a feel thing. World Edit, after that pistol round, he was probably feeling pretty fired up, ready to go. And then he gets another kill or two, in fact, with that AWP. So this is really just working out for USSR. Huiten is alive on the B side. He's going to pick up the first kill, though. He's now crouching on the site. He has to live, and it's not going to happen. Kibakin will spray him point blank, and that leaves Emilio and Michelele alive. World Edit spots a man at mid. That's Emilio down. And now Michelele, CT spawn. They're going to be running right to him, which is good. He's got the P250. If they get within lethal range, he could still pick off a kill here.
Yeah, almost managed to land the headshot, but not quite. A little bit confused about the one guy who was in here. Was it, I think, Quinton who was waiting in here. A little bit confused about the fact that he sort of went for that type of peek. I think the position he had was really good for taking them off as they went into the bombsite, but once you let them in the bombsite, once they actually get out where they have room to move around and you have the M4A1, how are you going to kill that many people with just 20 bullets? But, well, Delpan just needs one bullet in the middle, and Kibakin has gone down, and now the sixth round is off to a good start, and about time ESG, I think, make it onto the scoreboard here.
Well, we have to. I mean, the thing is right now they do look a little bit shaky still, but that double op play is now coming into it for ESG. Looks like I'm losing my connection. Are we still on Skype? Can you still hear me?
Yeah, I can still hear you just fine, and my game also seems to be working, so hopefully it's just a minor issue.
Okay, hopefully. Fingers crossed, but Right now, it just seems like ESG, they're willing to fall back. They're not going to be pushing anywhere. I like that they've got it locked down on the B site. One man on the site proper. Never leave the site unattended, especially when you have a man advantage like this on the defense. You never want to do that. So USSR are going to have to work to get in here.
Yeah, they will. Mike Lilly with an open Delpan with 1-2, I think, is, you know, fight fire with fire. That's what ESG are thinking. If they have two ops, we're just going to pick up two ops as well, and we'll still be in a pretty good state. Although, right now, World Edit actually doesn't have his, so I'm wondering if they lost the last round and I just didn't notice.
World Edit? No, I think he swapped out for the AK. He definitely had it a few seconds ago, so I think they just swapped out for the AK, but there's Lamp finding Emilio. And Michael Lilly is the one holding it cross, but it's just going to be the one man, Latro. He's going to back off, and now it's going to be the B-split play after all. But there's a great defense from Rogue. Two kills from him, stopping him cold on B-slope. And now Latro will finally manage to take him off, but Michael Lilly through the smoke picks off Latro.
And nicely done. World Edit going to go down as well. A little bit of a shame that Rogue wanted to peek with the pistol. No real reason he should do that, because they could actually get to him. But I think he still got the first two kills, so he did his job just fine. Don't want to criticize too much here. And that puts ESG on the board as well. 5-1. They are on the less favored side, so I think, all things considered, they're going to be in a decent state here.
Oh, yeah, dude, this is excellent. This is truly waking up. I mean, I like to see that Michael Lilly, you know, that this is a strategy that ESG can actually use, because Michael Lilly has already demonstrated that he's quite a capable opper. This, that he didn't start with the op when we first started seeing him, obviously, with like LGB and all that. We didn't really see him using the op too much, but with time, it seems that he's put more and more time into that rifle, and he's definitely become a scary opper. And, you know, you double that up with Delpan, who obviously it's just Delpan. Everybody knows that Delpan is one of the best ops in the world, flat out. That's a very deadly combo that you have on ESG. And I think it's definitely one of, like, it's not an ace up their sleeve, but it's definitely one of their strong cards that they like to, that they're going to try and throw around and play.
Yeah, I absolutely agree. And I still think this team could make it quite far if they manage to just pull themselves together and do a fine job and just, you know, stick playing together, or at least find a core combination of players that works for a long time, sort of like Fnatic has been up to for a while now, just, you know, swapping out individual players, but keeping a core as long as you possibly can. I think that'd be a good move for ESG. Then they could definitely have a real impact. I mean, we already saw them with DreamHack Summer do quite well. Just to talk about, you know, old members coming, old people coming back and playing. I don't know if you, I say old people, that sounds like he's old, but you noticed Maxaki was back playing again.
He put that post up on Reddit just today saying that he was back full time.
Yeah, so if you guys want to support, actually, I think the plan is for him to try and put sort of full time basically into playing competitive Counter-Strike. So if you guys want to help him, I think it's a cool idea. And Maxaki is a really good player, so I'd be surprised if we don't see him in a top team within those 6 months. You guys can go to Twitter. It's official Maxaki, I think. Pretty easy.
There's a couple things there to mention with Maxaki, is that he was actually a teammate of Michael Lilly and Hoiten, who are playing for ESG right now when LGB first started up. And this was even before they were LGB. So I think they took Maxaki off to bring in Dennis.
They did.
But, yeah, exactly. But still, Maxaki getting back into the mix, we'll have to see if, you know, a team is going to be able to pick him up. It seems like he's actually got together a team of his own. So we'll have to keep our eye on them to see how they do. But right now, Delpan with a sick op Dragon Lore. That skin is amazing. He's looking at upper dark right now. And again, he's got a very aggressive position, and this, which is something that's just like purely Delpan, right? Up close, he's not afraid. Usually, oppers will hold back from plateau or from sight. Delpan just gets right up in the ninja corner and, you know, holds that angle, no fear.
Well, everyone else would be thinking, oh, if I miss the shot, I'm going to be trapped in this weird corner and they can just get to me. But not Delpan. He's not even worried. Mike Killilly is covering short as well, and USSR really wanted an early pickoff, and they tried to get one up on catwalk, but couldn't really connect with it. Now Emilio and Mike Killilly being right here, I think this is a really, really strong setup. Mike Killilly missing a crucial shot, and that's going to get him killed. Hurting down from the pit, going to pick up one, but Emilio goes down, and this is looking really good.
This is looking like a situation where ESG absolutely have to hold on to long. The only problem is that nobody is really pressuring Hoiten right now. So he's not going to be able to really do anything about this bomb going down. His teammates have rotated in, but look at Latro's position at the top of mid. He catches that rotation. Delpan doesn't even know what hit him.
Yeah, very, very smart. Hoiten will take down Latro, but that's actually too late at this point. I mean, USSR have everything they want, and you can see ESG aren't even going for it. So very clever leaving that one man behind.
Well, it's also, I mean, just horrible right now for ESG's money. Huiten has got 5K, then there's like 2.6 on Delpan, but that's pretty much all the money that's worth mentioning here for ESG at this point. So USSR winning this round is going to be big. USSR, on the other hand, have plenty of money, so they're not afraid to try and hunt down these rifles. World Edit even going to find Roke in the end. So very fine kill there by World Edit. You know, you want to make sure that you make ESG spend that money, whatever money they have in the coming round. USSR, they want to make sure that ESG are going to be cracking it.
Man, losing that last rifle, though, is pretty painful for ESG. And they were actually sort of the ones looking for World Edit. Maybe they should respect him a little bit more. He's got 9, 2, and 1. He's only died the one time in the first 7 rounds of this game. Aggressive push up the middle for Michelele being boosted up. He's going to run right into Keep It Real. And at that range, this P250 is exactly that powerful. 2 kills coming up. Picks up the AK and just keeps charging. So a lot of energy here for the CT side. Emilio looking for the one Deke in the middle, and it's not really connecting with anything at all. Finally going to get a body shot in, but pretty little bit too late. Still, they do have the advantage right now, I'd say.
Yeah, that's very odd that Emilio couldn't get that kill on Lamp. That seems like a kill 9 times out of 10 there. So somehow Emilio doesn't pull it off. But this is a great anti-eco. I mean, this is not an anti-eco, but I mean an eco rather for ESG. Look at this. They've already managed to pick up 2 guys. They've done a sick amount of damage to Lamp. So he's pretty much useless for USSR now. And the rest of USSR, they're making the right call at this point. Just group up, push as 3, and count on just the superior firepower to get the job done at this point.
Yeah, let's see. Mike Lilly's going to pop flash out, or flash that's worth knowing this one. So he's going to flash it out right there and then runs into the smoke. And oh, great. That was actually hitting one of those kills. Mike Lilly going to turn around and take down Lamp. And that's a quad kill here for ESG and Mike Lilly. Really nice done. But yeah, that one pop flash, very popular, very common. I bet most of you already know it. But you saw just how effective that was. And
he even
that's
saves
gonna...
the AWP.
Oh yeah, he even does that. You're right.
So it's like they still managed to keep Huiten in the bank. He's Huiten, you know, he saved his rifle. He lived through that last round. Now he's got 9K even after buying. So ESG have got options. Even if they were to lose this round, they got some options, you know, going into the next one. Whereas they could drop for Delpan, they could drop 2 rifles for 2 teammates, pretty much. So we should be looking at an ESG buy regardless of the outcome here. But USSR now are the ones who are starting to feel a bit of the hurt in their wallets. They're definitely getting low on the money, so they have to shut down ESG hard right here.
That'd be really good for them, because I mean I can't help but shake a feeling that eventually ESG are just gonna go, you know, completely nuts. And I think once they get up top, and actually once USSR eco even one round, I think there's a really good chance that ESG could just basically landslide out of control, and they may lose control of the game entirely. Already the World did it very low, getting shot over at long, and now they are still setting up for a B-split push, so they're not really indecisive. I like the fact that they're making a choice even though they are down, man. Some teams just kind of get stuck doing nothing at all. But this mid-push is going to be really, really difficult. Emilio's going to be jumping up on the box, trying to see if he can catch anyone through. Looking over the smoke, and actually just shoots through the smoke. Doesn't even care about looking inside the bomb site. Delpan's waiting, and backup is going to be just in time. Michael Hill is there, and World Edit does get a kill in, but it is going to be too late.
It is. I mean, World Edit's got 6 HP now. Emilio is waiting right here at the doors. World Edit, he's making noise as well. Emilio with the spray through the boxes.
And we saw the tracers on the other side of that box as well. That was really cool. I do love that effect that Valve added in one of the patches. Really nice. So, yeah, well, not really much World Edit could have done in that situation. A bomb plant would have been a miracle in the 1-on-3 like that. So that makes it 6-3, and now USSR are back to ecoing, and we'll see how far this landslide is going to go for ESG, or if there is going to be a stop to it eventually. I mean, USSR have been playing well, so I don't want to discredit what they've been up to, but now you've got to wonder if ESG have woken up. Actually, Kibakan takes the first kill, so great start.
Yeah, this is, I mean, that's that P250 already put to use. Latro gets caught, however, by Michelele with that AWP. But ESG now just trying to lock things down. USSR, it seems like Kibakan, you know, since he's joined the team, he's had a pretty good influence, because USSR are definitely putting in some good work versus a team that is not to be taken lightly. ESG have caught people off guard. They've taken out top teams online. So, I mean, this is not a team to just be kind of like poo-poo and say, okay, well, we should be able to walk through them. USSR definitely putting up a very solid fight right now.
Oh yeah, and I mean, just to talk about Kibakan for a little bit, Estelpan is shooting away fools in the middle, already taking a good double kill. Not going to get the third one just yet, but he just repeats again and again and again. Very typical Delpan. Until he goes down, he's just going to keep going. Keep It Real will drop. But Kibakan was actually one of the guys that was picked up together with Seized. It was Seized and Kibakan who joined VODS Pro initially. So, sorry, what?
Anders, they joined Navi.
Oh yeah, sorry, I'm so confused. It's because I was
Snacks and Bialy.
Yeah, you're right. That's what I meant. But Yeah, you're absolutely right. Sorry about that. Yeah, so yeah, joining Na'Vi obviously before Edward replaced him, but so he's definitely a player of some caliber. Don't want to just discredit them at all. But right now they have a great push going out on long, and it's going to be Mike Lilly up in the A bomb site, just trying to see if he can actually defend somehow here.
That was a sick flash combo, and then they just punished ESG for going two guys long. Delpan point blank on Lamp is going to catch him through the gap, and even legs Latro as he goes by. Delpan is having a field day. This is him in his element at this point. He even gets the one through the edge on the smoke, and Delpan, he's wreaking havoc. Oh, four kills, God. Misses the last one that could have got him the ace.
Yeah, he's still alive. He's going to re-peek once again. Keep it real. He's the only one alive. Delpan has just made their whole team vanish, and it's going to be Rogue to pick up the last one, but what an incredible series. I mean, there might not be a huge amount on the line here. I think ESG right now in Star Series have 4 wins and 1 loss, so they're doing fairly well, and USSR are much lower on the scoreboard than that, so I think ESG don't... they're not too worried right now, but that sequence was great.
That's what we talk about when we mention, you know, Delpan being so aggressive up close. Like, he's so comfortable with the AWP, it's almost like a shotgun for him. It's almost like Kenny S, same sort of style, where if you get up close, Kenny S can be the kind of player to land those sort of up close shots with the AWP and not get flustered. Delpan, he just does it. He makes it work, and we couldn't have had a clearer example there. He does get rushed down at mid doors though, so good play there by World Edit with the P250 again managing to pick up a kill, but the bomb has been kind of dropped out in the open, and that's not going to help USSR now that ESG have closed in the defense.
No, it really won't. Rogue is going to pick up the slack in the B-bomb site, and the last two members here, I don't know, the goal is pretty just see if they can kill somebody. There is a deagle on Keep It Real, so maybe we can see a nice one deke here, but it's not really connecting, and Rogue is going to make short work of them, and in comes Rogue. Yeah, actually, that's going to be Rogue to pick up the last kill. He'll Emilio maybe steal that away, but looking pretty good here. 6-6, and ESG have now won 5 rounds in a row, and USSR haven't got very many bomb plants either.
They are kind of strapped for cash. Even after losing several rounds in a row now, exactly the 5 rounds in a row, they're getting quite a bit of money when they lose. If they can get a plant now, this is what USSR are all about. They need to get plants, and more importantly, they need to shut down ESG right now, because ESG have now reached 6 rounds on the CT side, and that just cannot be allowed by USSR. They absolutely have to get the remaining 3 rounds, I think, to have a chance once we switch over at the half.
Yeah, oh, Keep It Real doing something smart here, jumping up all the way on the bang ledge here down by Pit, and if they re-peek him, they might not realize that's where he's going to be. We'll see it from Michael Lennon's perspective. He's going to walk up, he does spot one, he gets actually shot through that pole, and now he's kind of low grenade to follow, and actually they just shoot him right through the box. Nice play from USSR. Now Emilio has actually already let a couple of people cross over, and this is going to be a really difficult retake, though. Great shot from Emilio will take down Kibakken.
Holy hell, that was fast. But he's going to peek out too far from Element, and Latro catches him from long. Now the bomb will just get chucked across. Good punish there on the World Edit. Drops him low down to 17. Delpan with the leg. But still, this is USSR having to waste so much time before they can finally get the plant that ESG are right on top of them now. They're right there on CT slow. Two guys with one coming up on short. USSR have full control of long, though, so this is going to be very tough for them.
Oh, Keep It Real shooting down Rogue through his teammate's leg. That's some nice precision work. Delpan goes down, and now it is on Hütten versus Keep It Real in a one-on-one. Bomb already being defused. Keep It Real not peeking far enough, and they're going to lose the round because of it. He actually doesn't even kill Hütten at the end, so after a great triple kill, it's a bit of a sad way to lose the round.
You have to wonder if it was communicated properly where the plant was. If his teammates were just like, okay, we're planning long, right? That's not your standard long plant. Your long plant is in the corner of that little plateau, or closer to the edge, obviously, to be able to give Keep It Real the best chance to just stop that. The only place that Keep It Real could actually stop that defuse from was up on plateau. And Hütten, he called it perfectly. He was like, okay, pro players don't defuse or don't fake the defuse. I'm just gonna go for it. And Keep It Real was too slow on the drop, or too slow to figure it out.
Yeah, and that says something really important about the way you communicate with your teammates in Counter-Strike. It's so important that you can explain exactly where something is, and if it's a little bit to the right, like, you know, just 10 centimeters to the left or the right, it makes a really big difference in those tight situations. Nice kill down on long, World Edit goes down, and ESG looking to see if they can take the 8th round here.
Yeah, they've just completely spun out of control now since they picked up that 8th round. They've just been, 6 rounds in a row now for the Swedes, and they don't seem to be in any kind of position to slow up. They're not worried about money going into the remaining round of this half. So ESG can pretty much do whatever they want, but they've got the man advantage now, and it will be the straight B push. We do have Delpan on the site, gets clipped immediately by Kibiken, though. Great kill there by Kibiken to secure the site for his team. Now they just need to get some smokes down, but they've run out of nades, and ESG are there to punish.
Yeah, Rogue picking up more kills here, doing a fine job, and Latro's going to be alone without much time, and, well, not even going to make it work. Rogue with a triple kill, and actually top fragging at 16-2-9, so doing a very good job. Delpan close by at 14 kills, and we are moving into the last round of the first half with ESG just, I mean, as we said, there was that chance always that once they got up and running that there'd be no stopping them, and that's pretty much what we've seen.
It's just, it's that example of Dust2 being a bit of a momentum map, more so than ever now. It really does seem like once a team starts being able to chain a few rounds together, they're so difficult to stop. World Edit does get the drop on the man, though. That's going to be Hoiten taken out from Wong, but Emilio is here. He doesn't get flashed either, so he's able to pick up the kill, and that's a two-man advantage now for ESG going into the 15th round here.
Delpan with a really aggressive push up into Lower Dark will take down one player as well. That was pretty cheeky, but again, just more evidence that Delpan just doesn't play an AWP like most people do, and it's really interesting to watch. Of course, it has huge risk, as we've seen already, when he pushes too long, it's a little bit too much.
Michaelele is a little bit high-strung here. I'm wondering about the communication on ESG's part as well. Michaelele just so focused on mid-doors that Delpan walks back and Michaelele shoots him in the back. So that was a bit of a mistake there from ESG, but it will be Michaelele holding on A site. He gets the first one. Lamp is down. Now it's down to Latro, and it's not going to be for long. Michaelele with the final two frags, but there we have it. ESG, they run it back, a near-perfect remainder of that half, like eight rounds in a row, just shutting USSR down.
Very nicely done. 9-6 and 8th, as you said, eight of those rounds in a straight row here at the end for the Swedish team. Now, going into the second half, probably going to be pretty hard for USSR to come back from this. But either way, I think they showed some real promise here. I mean, they're just up against a team that is really strong, as we've seen. So that's what we've seen actually a lot in the SLTV Star Series so far. It's just that sometimes we get matchups that are, a little bit one-sided, but that's how it goes. If you're just joining us, then welcome to the channel. This is Room on Fire, and we are casting the SLTV Star Series Season 10. Hope you guys are enjoying it. Remember to follow and subscribe and all of that stuff, and you'll help us out a lot. We'll keep the channel active, and on Wednesday, guys, we'll be having our own Case King of the Hill tournament, cool by Alpenfoon. Hope you guys are ready for it. Welcome to the show again. I'm Anders, with me Semler, of course, and we are going to be ready with the second half here, Semler.
Now this is it. Now we get to see whether USSR are going to be able to shut down ESG, because we have been seeing teams do better on the CT side of Dust2. Are USSR going to be in position to actually shut down ESG and get the right read? Already ESG just spotting mid. Three guys, in fact, just putting shots down through mid doors, hoping to do some damage to USSR. The guys crossing over for B site, but that's just not happening, actually. USSR getting through pretty much unscathed.
Yes, indeed. 9-6 here. And body armor on three of the players from USSR, two grenades, one on World Edit, he's in the middle, and one on Lamp, is up in the A bomb site. Not really sure what to make of it, but obviously ESG have invested in a few more grenades, including smokes, so that suggests they are going to be going for a proper execute. And the way they're setting up right now, it looks like it's going to be a B push eventually. Delpan, he's going to use his smoke on, well, actually, wow, top of mid. That's a weird smoke. I have no idea what that's meant to do.
Maybe try and throw USSR for a loop here. Latro, well, one shot, one kill on Delpan with the P2K. That was very nice. Delpan, no real time for him to react, but the flashes go through mid doors, and now it's going to be the speed up here. ESG, they've got the smoke down, cutting off CT. They're going straight up B.
Yeah, they are, and Latro's going to go down. World Edit drops, and this is not looking good. Lamp trying to shoot through. He will actually... No, that's Kibaken, so he's connecting with the kill. So Lamp still to get one, and he's alone. Will be taken down. Emilio and Michaelele with a double each, and that is going to give the round to ESG. So, I don't know. After that first kill, it looked like maybe it could have gone USSR's way.
It seemed like it. I mean, yeah, that was a really nice kill there by Latro, and that's... I mean, you think that's going to slow ESG down, but rather than try and take the fight on short chase after Latro even it up to 4-on-4, ESG, they just set up for a B-split and then land all the shots. That's the most important thing. They were even waiting around for the rotation to come through CT and got a couple freebies there. So it's just ESG knowing exactly how to read USSR and what they're going to do. They now have the guns. Delpan going with the P250 instead of a rifle, not really willing to spend any money this round so that he can get that AWP as quickly as possible. That's pretty much all that ESG have got going right now. USSR just taking damage at the start.
Yeah, that is just not the It's not the best start here for the Russian team, and they do need a pretty big comeback to happen. I mean, once they get up to hopefully what will be a double up setup from Keep It Real and World Edit, maybe we can see them stringing some rounds together. There is always a chance, but I think this is very close to the end, it feels like. And ESG making some good decisions as well, this time going up on long, leaving Delpan with just a pistol in the middle, which is not really a big risk. If he had a rifle, I'd really hate this kind of setup because it means they could steal it away from him. But if they kill Delpan, all they lose is a pistol.
Yeah, it's not the end of the world. He is going to get overwhelmed, however. He's caught in a corner. He's about to get, well, caught in a crossfire, really. And there you go. Keep It Real picks up the first. He almost gets the second as well, dropping Emilio down to 31. So good damage dealt here by USSR. They haven't even really invested too much in this round, it seems, USSR. If we take a look, actually two of their members did go for P250 armor. The rest of them, however, just buying pistols, which is a little bit weird, seeing as how usually you would have the whole team going for armor. Kevlar helmet, you know, not really spreading it around. So I don't know about the whole half-half sort of thing, where it's like, okay, two of us will go for it, the other three won't, and then our money is going to be kind of skewed going into the 19th round.
Yeah, I'm guessing, I mean, since it's Keep It Will and World Edit who didn't buy any armor, I'm wondering why Kipakin didn't then, because I don't think he's going to be picking up an AWP, so that's just very confusing. He will be picking up armor this round, though, so now I really have no idea why he didn't do it last round. That seems like just a basic issue here for USSR.
I wonder where exactly Kipakin is going to go to use that armor as well. I mean, it seems like he's going to be the man holding B, so maybe an aggressive push out on B. He is getting up close, so that Kevlar could make the difference with this position that he's holding if ESG just rush around the corner. Kvakin, though, is going to take the peek, faces two guys, and gets instantly gibbed, so there's nothing really coming from it at all from him.
Nah, well, they're going to go down there really just hunting, and over on long as well, one guy's going to get caught now. It's Keep It Real going down. Pretty quick succession. Actually, he's just relaxing here in the corner. That does look pretty comfortable. That's going to be 12 and 6, and we are moving into the 19th round, where finally there's one AWP and another one picked up on Keep It Real. So prediction came true and wasn't really a hard one to make since they did the same on the terrorist side. We'll see if it makes a difference. And actually, Delpan, and this is surprising, hasn't picked up an AWP. He's picked up a Galil even in the last round, so not really sure what that's about.
No, but then they've got so much money right now on T side, it doesn't really seem like they care. And they're going for a quick B rush, and it's actually working. Hoiten and Emilio both getting the entries. Clear up that B site so quickly. USSR, they're still just left standing on the A site. Lamp actually just like hopping in place for a second there, going, well, there's the round. It's done already. Yeah.
That's disappointing, isn't it? Because they did actually have the players there. They were just a little bit slow, and they ran right into a flashbang, and that kind of sealed their fates. Now, yeah, they just got to try and hold on to these rifles, but it will be ESG picking up a 13th round, and if they lose these rifles, it's really going to be a 14th to follow, because they won't have any money to rebuy.
Delpan going to take a peek at A site. Keep It Real is still alive on A slope, though. He should be able to pick up Delpan before Delpan gets too close. Delpan really closing the gap, and there you go. Keep It Real. Headshot point blank on Hoiten. He will get caught by Delpan, but there's still two members alive here for USSR, and Latro taking a peek at the end. That's almost as if he's just playing with fire.
Yes.
Why take the peek if you're trying to save your gun?
I don't know. I mean, really, really trying hard to throw the game right now, it seems like. But I think they are just getting a little bit desperate as well. Delpan actually steals the AWP, which is very annoying. Because, well, we know how good he is with it. And he's going to be controlling long for now, which does... And look at this. This is exactly what Delpan's all about, right? No one else would be seen pushing out long alone in this position. But Delpan's just like, whatever. I'm just going to, like, you know, push alone. Seems like they're playing... this is almost matchmaking style coming out from Delpan at this point.
Yeah, this is so hard to predict. This is the sort of thing. It's really just like... You cut Delpan loose to kind of do what he wants. Good flash in. There's a double stack on short, though. USSR with the defense. Lamp putting that rifle that he saved to work already, getting one shot. And Delpan should get an opportunity. He's going to miss on Kvakin, though. Kvakin rushing forward, and he gets the kill. Now Kvakin's going to have an AWP on long. This just made ESG's life a whole lot harder.
Yeah, it did, but Latro goes down in the middle, and they're just going to be rotating back towards the B-bomb site. So I think this is where ESG have a pretty good mix, right? Because they have Delpan, who's just nuts, and Mike Killele, we've seen what he can do as well. So just having those two players alone that you can sort of unleash and do crazy things, that is a really, really good combination. But then also having the presence of mind to actually just make rotations like that, even though, you know, you're in a 3-on-1, you could probably just go and kill the guy on long and win the round anyway. But making the safe choice and then going for the B-bomb side, I think that's a pretty nice mix.
Oh, Delpan. All right, well, there's the first shot, and this is not a round that USSR are willing to actually give up, or they don't want to be a man down already. This is the problem. ESG are on the brink of getting match point, and they need to make everything count. World Edit finding Roken Upper Dark, though, that's going to be a big blow dealt here to the offense. USSR now slowly bringing it back, and now they've managed to set up the defense as well. ESG are currently spread out all across the map, just looking to see if USSR are going to peek out anywhere. But USSR, at this point, they're really just locking it down solid. They have a man covering the cross. That's Keep It Real with the AWP looking towards that A site. They have a man at long. World Edit, though, I don't agree with him actually leaving B site. Latro is going to be holding B slope, and that's all that they should have here, holding B slope. World Edit coming out here like this is risky business, and he's going to get punished.
Yeah, so you turn out to be exactly right, and he could have got killed like he did, but you, even if you weren't right about that, you could still have been routed in the fact that they could have just lost the B bomb site basically to some guy walking in. So it's a big risk to take. You're definitely right about that. Now it's a 4-on-3, and you're right, this is about to be match and map point here for ESG if they can just take this round. Keep It Real though with a pretty good op shot. Now question is, can they stop Emilio flashing himself in down on long? Gonna be running out with the AK and does take down Keep It Real. Next in line is Lamp, who almost dies. AK versus M4, but he comes out on top. The bomb site though, well, the bomb is going to go down, and Michael Ele is looking down on long, misses the shot on Lamp, but these barrels are impenetrable, and he is going to go down eventually. Now Latra alone rushes in a 1-on-2, doesn't really have much of a chance here. He's just going to be looking for some sick headshots, but ESG are playing it smartly, and Michael Ele will pick up the last kill. 15-6 here.
Nicely done there by ESG, just relying on Michael Ele to stay alive and get the job done. Just very clean work in the end. And Roke, I don't know if that's a misbuy, but he just bought a negative. And he's giving it to Emilio.
Oh, yeah. So, well, I mean, I think ESG, I don't want to say they're not taking it seriously at all, but I think they realize that they are going to win this game even if they screw up horribly here. I think they feel very confident.
All right, let's see exactly how this pans out here. Kabakken is alive on the B side. He spotted out Roke. Good damage to Roke, actually. That's going to chase him away. So USSR coming out ahead in the exchange. Lamp is just currently waiting patiently in pit. He's looking for the opportunity. There's the flash. This could be a big opportunity for him to actually rack up some kills. He needs to stay alive and actually land those shots. His teammates are rotating in to support him as well. And this is falling apart here for ESG. They're about to get caught out, and there's the crossfire.
Yeah, really, really good patience from Lamp, and it gets him 2 kills. Lantra picking up one of them. And Krypton and Roke just have to try and see if they can find at least a couple of kills here, or maybe even bring it back from a 2-on-4, but that's a 1-on-4. Roke alone, and they know exactly where he is.
Well, they know that he's up on short. Keep It Real's gonna spot him with the FAMAS. Not the best gun, but Kabakken is actually gonna be the one doing the majority of the damage, so I guess he didn't hit anything there, Keep It Real. Regardless, though, that is gonna be the round for USSR, so they do manage to bring it back, and now I'm wondering if Roke isn't regretting dropping all that money on that negative.
Well, they actually still had money, which is pretty incredible, but you're right, you know, don't really want to throw anything too much away, although it would take 8 rounds in a row here for USSR to force the draw. There's no overtime, but I think that is still somewhat unlikely. Rush is going to be going on towards the B bomb side here. This time, Kabakken in a much better position, does great amount of damage, and World Dead is there to help out. He goes down, though, and Kabakken falls next, and they have to go for this retake, but man, it's going to be tough.
And Lamp just rotating in. I mean, Lamp is about to get caught as well. No, it's actually Emilio just holding an upper dark. He's just going to be listening at this point. Watches for the rotation. Lamp doing a lot of damage to Emilio. Good HE nade, but Emilio sees it coming, backs off, doesn't die from it. Lamp has to be careful, though. Emilio's rotating into lower dark. This is the mind games coming out now.
Yeah, I think just the fact that he spotted him right there, that makes the whole difference. If that should have worked for Lamp, he should have been completely undetected. But they did discover him, and now it's going to be 16-7. ESG taking the victory here on Dust2 against USSR, who they did show us that they had some skill and some talent, but they were up against a really tough team. So not really too surprising. It is the Swedes who come out on top with the victory. And that is going to put us on to the next match, boys, which is going to be LDLC versus Reason, coming up in about 10 minutes. So stay tuned, don't go anywhere, and we will be right back after.